Насос Теодоридис е член на Комитетот за човекови права на во моментов најпопуларната политичка партија во Грција, Сириза. Тој е одговорен за секторот за малцинствата и истовремено е голем и искрен пријател на македонците, и тоа не само на оние што живеат во Грција. За него е сосема прифатливо тоа што нашата земја се вика Македонија, но личните ставови на членовите и ставовите на партијата не секогаш се исти, вели Теодоридис во ексклузивно интервју за македонската радиотелевизија.
What can we expect from Syriza and its leader, Mr. Tsipras, in case he becomes the new prime minister of Greece in terms of the name issue and regarding the rights of the Macedonian minority that lives here in Greece and also the properties of the refugees of the civil war?
It is sure that there will be a new atmosphere after a victory of Syriza in the next elections. The whole foreign policy will be based on the ideals of peace and mutual understanding between neighboring people. This is a very important concept inside the party of Syriza. And we will think that it will be turned into a realistic foreign policy and not a nationalistic one like it is now and it was before in the past. We think also that Syriza will be able to solve some important issues of human rights, and first of all the issue of the political refugees, because already we have submitted in the parliament a question long time ago asking from the government to allow to all these people to come back in Greece, and it was an official question submitted in the parliament from the party of Syriza, because we think that it was a discrimination against those people who were excluded from the legislation of the early 80s. And as a government, we are going to finish this kind of discrimination.
It's amazing what you're saying. So, can we expect that Mr. Tsipras would be the first Greek prime minister in a long time that will start to respect the interim accord with Macedonia and the judgment from the court in Hague regarding the illegal veto on Macedonia's Euro-Atlantic integrations?
I believe that under a Syriza administration there will be a spirit of understanding, and the whole issue will be closed in a friendly way, and that a solution that satisfies both sides can be more easily found by politicians who are not who do not share nationalistic views. The official position of Syriza is the mixed name for the Republic of Macedonia, and I think that there can be found a solution in that direction.
I just wanted to make this clear. Okay, Syriza is for composite name with a geographic qualification, but is this erga omnes solution?
Yes, this is the official position of Syriza right now, an erga omnes position with a geographical identification. But it is very important the spirit that inspires politicians who sit in a table for negotiations. And I really believe that Syriza has the political will to solve this matter in a way that will also satisfy the people of Macedonia.
Well, Macedonia would be a nice erga omnes solution.
Yes.
What is your personal position regarding the eventual solution on the name issue?
My personal position is that the people of Macedonia has the right to self-determination, which means that this country and every country of the world has the right to choose its own constitutional name, and this is not the matter of a neighboring country. Of course, we have to fight against nationalism in both sides, because only in this way we can build friendly relations between the two countries.
You know, Mr. Tsipras was this close to becoming one of my favorite foreign politicians because of his new, refreshing and very honest positions on Greece, on the crisis, on the international community, etc. But then we heard his positions on the name issue, and those positions were not that new and refreshing. And why is it that Mr. Tsipras won't take a position like yours, for example, but his positions are moving more towards those of, I don't know, Karamanlis, Samaras, Papandreou? Because a couple of weeks ago we heard him saying that Macedonia had irredentistic pretensions towards the northern parts of Greece, for example.
The truth is that inside Syriza there are many political views on these issues and in other issues as well. There is not only one opinion saying that we are in favor of mixed name. There is also other position like mine saying that we want the self-identification. As you understand, there is these declarations are a result of a compromise inside Syriza. So it's not easy every time to express the clear positions of the one side or the other side. Even if these declarations were not expressed in the best way, they do not reflect a hostility towards Macedonian people and the state of Macedonia. I would like to emphasize that he said that the name is not the big problem. According to all nationalists in Greece, the name is the main problem. So for the first time, Tsipras emphasized that the name is not the main problem. The main problem is to fight against nationalism in both sides. And what he meant was that some articles saying about protection of minorities in other countries can be interpreted by nationalistic forces as a kind of interference in neighboring countries, which is not true, and he was certainly right on this. But it was the first time that he clearly said that apart from the name, there are other things that we can discuss and agree, and then the name loses its importance, because the importance of the name is something fake and something constructed by the nationalists.
Грчкиот премиер Самарас во моментов се наоѓа под голем притисок од меѓународната заедница, не само за економските прашања, туку и за постигнување на компромис со Македонија, открива Теодоридис, нагласувајќи дека ако не постоеше ваков притисок и ако се зависеше од Самарас, тогаш сигурно е дека ќе се случеше уште поголемо оддалечување во односите меѓу двете соседни земји.
In meantime, we have Prime Minister Samaras, who is pretty much known as an extreme nationalist on especially on the Macedonian issue. So what do you think having Samaras as Prime Minister means for the name issue and for the rights of the Macedonian minority? Does it mean progress or it means a regress? And would you agree that the current Greek government is very much constructive like they claim they are?
I think that if it was for Mr. Samaras to decide what to do, I think that we would have a deterioration in the relations of two countries, because this specific politician shares very nationalistic views. Not only him, but many other forces inside his party are very hostile to any kind of solution in that issue. On the other side, according to all information we have right now, Samaras is under a lot of international pressure because of the economic problem of Greece. The West is pushing him for negotiations and for a compromise in the Macedonian issue as well. I really think that he is not in position now for more conflict in with the West, because he already chose a way in his policy to be extremely friendly with all the Western countries, and so I believe he will propose a solution, and as history says, as you probably know, some compromises and some solutions can be found sometimes through politicians who are very nationalist, because it's more difficult for other nationalists to accuse them as traitors of their country. So he has the face of nationalist, and he can easily find a compromise, but not because he believes that himself. We all remember that he was very nationalist as a foreign minister in the past.
So you are a member of the Committee for Human Rights of Syriza. How would you describe the current situation with the human rights of the Macedonian minority in Greece?
There are a lot of issues that have not been solved yet, and we will try step by step to solve them. Apart from the fact how we will call the specific group or the neighboring country. The human rights are human rights, and they have to exist in any case. So there is the problem of self-determination of the associations of Macedonian groups in Greece.
Also with registration.
Exactly. And the Greek courts do not obey to the European Court of Human Rights, so there is an important violation of the right to association according to the European Court of Human Rights, and this is an issue that can be dealt with very easily, because we can be based on the decision of the European Court. This is not something radical, it's something legal according to the Court of Strasbourg, and in a second stage, since the position of Syriza is to is for Greece to ratify the convention framework for the national minorities, we believe that if this happens, then minority groups will be able to found their own education foundations. They can have their own local media. They can be protected by all the articles of this convention framework for the national minorities that has been signed by Greece but not ratified yet. So we have a lot of work to do in that field, because under this convention we can solve a lot of problems for the minority of Macedonians.
Do you think that this improvement would also apply to the right of the Macedonian children to have Macedonian names here in Greece, because it's forbidden for now?
I think that the convention will be a great progress, and if it will be a part of the Greek legislation officially, then it will be much more easy through legal and other ways to achieve even more rights for the members of the Macedonian minority. And of course, I agree also with what you said.
Well, thank you very much. I really hope that in time we can see more and more Greek politicians thinking just like the way you do. Thank you very much. It was a pleasure.
Thank you very much.